Hi guys, Kirk and Jay and family and friends here with Kirk Giordano Plastering. Today, first of all, happy holidays, guys. Today what we're going to do is we're going to reinforce this cinder block chimney. Why? Because it's deteriorating here and there, it's cracking, and it's doing a whole bunch of stuff that the homeowners don't like. They contracted with an engineer who came out. He said, Kirk, what would you do? I said, well, I'd go with a deep furred wire. I'd go with an inch of stucco. He says, well, we're going to do one better than that. And I thought, okay, don't listen to old Kirk. So this is what they come up with. They put this wire, this is generally for concrete. They've screwed it into the grout. Then they've placed the corners here at an odd angle. Why did they compress the corners? What they did was they took a corner aid and squished it flat like that to come up with 2 inches. Why do they want 2 inches? For the extra strength. I personally thought an inch was fine. Anyway, so 2 inches, this is 2 inches. Their screeds are 2 inches on the side there. Now what does that mean, guys, to take a look at this? All right, that corner, this corner, have to line up with this. Now normally, this is, it's all lined up here. Now, you might think, man, how many coats do you got to do to go 2 inches thick? Well, technically, 3/8 a coat. Figure it out. But Jason and I, we're going to start at the bottom. Generally, we start at the top because we're putting so much mud. But when you hit this rebar, it's going to have a tendency to want to fall. So I'll start from the top. We'll work our way right up. And what I'll do is say, like, I'll start here. My first coat is going to be on here. And I'm going to go real thick. I'm going to fill this out because my first coat right here is going to come this way, and then we're going to start in the middle. I'm probably going to go about a half inch to 3/4 possibly for my first coat. We're going to do that anywhere between 3 and 4 times to bring this out to 2 inches thick. Everything again has to align. So we're going to get busy. We're getting mud all over the place. We're going to set a board here. When we get to that stage, Jay and I will show you what I'm referring to, and then we'll show you how to do those scratch marks, which are pretty important. Again, you see this is blue? That's weldcrete, a bonding agent. Even the wire is coated because we want the stucco to adhere to the wire real well. So anyway, these fellas did a great job with this so-called, looks like rebar type of lath to me. Anyway, we're going to get started, and we'll show you when we get to that stage. Okay guys, we're going to get started here. I'll show you what I think the best way to do this is. Now granted, you see this corner? This corner is somewhat weird, so I'm holding it in place because it has a tendency to flex. Why is it flexing? Because it's 2 inches thick. It's bent. So the first thing I want to do, guys, is get some mud in it. And now, because we're doing 2 inches thick, I'm going much thicker than I would normally do, obviously. Now, when I get that part done, Jay's handling that side, I'm handling this side. And notice, I'm starting at the bottom. We're gonna work our way up. Why? Because if we start at the top, we will lose all kind of mud. And going to lose all kinds anyway. This is an odd thing we're doing, but I thought it'd be kind of interesting to show you folks. Anyway, we are out of mud. Lou's going to give us some more mud and we're going to get started. Notice how this is coming out. It's coming out because it can. That's why we're starting from the bottom. When we get this whole thing, the first coat, I'm going to scratch it and I'll show you, explain a little bit more about what the heck we're doing. All right, guys, first time I actually ever went over this, and it's a bit of a drag. But anyway, we got it done. Now what we want to do is we want to put some deep scratch marks in it, because in an hour, actually in about 40 minutes, this is going to be hard, where if I took a hammer, it won't come off. I doubt any of you guys will have to go this route because this isn't typical of what we do, but there's a lot of improvising. I've done fish ponds, We've stuccoed mountains, we've done retaining walls, we've done swimming pools, you name it, we have done it and can do it. It just takes a little bit of knowing what you're doing and how to do it. Okay guys, we are hustling, doing some weird stuff like this. What we do is we adjust our mud because first we found out it's a little too soupy. So we stiffened it up, a little bit more cement to make it so this first fat coat goes in there, because you see what happens, it's falling out. This is fun, it's quite the challenge. So, and these bars right here, I just had a suggestion, hey, let's remove the bars. And I said, hey, let's not remove the bars. Look how high up we are. I'd rather have them bars in the way and work around them than remove them bars, because once you take these bars off, guys, it sure does get scary. Did I mention, guys, that we're high up? And it's misting on us. This mist, I'll tell you, feels real good, because if it were a hot day, man, we'd be struggling. I just went and talked to my brother, Lou, and said, Lou, you going to the gym after this? Because he's done about a truckload already. He had to laugh. Anyway, guys, we're going up, and then what are we doing? We're coming right back down, starting it again, another 3/8, and doing the same thing. We'll spare you that second time, but we'll show you a little bit more as we get to that stage. All right, guys, this is our, this is the third, fourth coat? Third coat, guys. What we're doing is we're allowing each coat to set, which gives us the opportunity to put the next one. What we do here is, once we got this where we want it, and the base coat, both of those other coats are set, we rod it, darby it, take this guy here and make it all true and plumb and level, take it, see any holidays, just put it on there, just like so. That's going to give us a wall, true and plumb, when we get to that stage where we are almost, say like a couple holidays here, a couple here, and here, true it out with a darby or a rod. You could have a rod to do this, but a darby got handles, it's a lot easier. All right guys, this is after lunch, I'm doing the fun stuff now. We are getting 2 inches, chewing plumb and making it pretty and giving the cap a way to roll off. We don't want water sitting up here. So, anybody guess where we're at by looking at the location? We got San Francisco Bay on that side. And we got tennis courts. We got all kind of good stuff up here. But anyhow, we are doing the fun stuff. How I do love to do this. This part takes a little bit of skill. What I'm trying to do is round it all off and make it pretty. We want it so that the water sheds. We don't want this to hold water. So I'm finishing up this little piece here. And as soon as we're done, we're gonna go down and play tennis right down there. I'm kidding. There we go, and next thing is the floating. Okay guys, now's the real easy part. Once you get that mud on there and let it set for a while, it's just a matter of floating everything out. And what I generally do is put a slope on here so water doesn't set on the top. We clean this flashing. Make it pretty. It doesn't matter if water runs onto the stucco. It's good for the stucco. In fact, it's supposed to rain tonight. That's also good for the stucco. So we do it like so. Again, this is my favorite part, doing radiuses. This doesn't look good. The pigeons won't sit on it. Anyway, we are about to go down. We're almost to the end of this, and good thing, because we're running out of daylight. We'll see you when we get to the bottom and show you the ending. Okay guys, We are done with this chimney. That is three truckloads of sand and cement. It's the end of the day. We're tired. We're going to go home. It's close to Christmas.
Yeah, we just wanted to say Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays. When we started doing this 4 years ago, we didn't know where we'd end up. And now we've got, this will be about our 5 millionth view. We got about 10,000 subscribers. We get people emailing us, calling us every day, saying they love what we do. Since you guys like it, and we like doing it, we're going to keep doing it. Thanks for watching.
My name is Kirk.
And I'm Jason.
We thank you for watching, and as usual, we'll
see you guys on the next one.
Once again, folks, we thank you for watching, and I really enjoy all your comments.
If you guys like this video, please click the like button down below. And also, if you enjoy what we do, subscribe to our channel so we can keep making these videos for you.
My name is Kirk.
And Jay.
We thank you for watching, and from the entire Giordano family, we'll see you on the next one.